Hey guys, I'm here with a review. Not over Batman Arkham Asylum the game, just over its packaging, the contents of the Collector's Edition. Mainly because Mr. Octobotanus himself asked me to, because he values my opinion or something. So now this is the Xbox 360 version of the game. It and the PS3 version, from my understanding, are identical, except the PS3 version comes with a special code to download maps where you can play as the Joker, which does sound rather fun. I am hoping at some point this will be released for the Xbox 360, but we never know. Comes in this center box here, which I think I'll use more just to store this than anything. Nothing really special on this. Thump. Now you get this case here. This is where everything comes packaged, and the case is rather impressive. It's this nice, thick kind of plastic. Kind of has a aluminum feel to it, but it's nice and sturdy. I really like it. It may actually be like a really thin metal type thing. I don't know. But on the front here, you can see in gloss Batman Arkham Asylum Collector's Edition. On the back, you get the same kind of treatment: Arkham Asylum, Eidos, Rocksteady, DC, and Warner Brothers, and all those, and all this. A pretty cool feature included. I don't know if you really see it, but there's two little circles here. Well, there's magnets built into the bottom of the case. So, the Hybels dropped it. So the lid is actually, it's really secured. You can have it standing up and it's going to fall out. It's a minor touch, but I'm glad they included it. So now you can have it displayed without anything popping out. So let's get that down there. Open this up. Styrofoam! And this is the first thing you get out of the box. If I can actually get it out of there. You get your own Batarang. Now, this was something that I was actually really excited for. I did watch someone else's video on this before mine arrived, so I knew what to expect, and I'm still pretty let down. Now, I do understand why it is a really thin plastic and why it is permanently attached to the stand. That's so people or kids won't grab their Batarang and chase their parents around throwing it at them, because then they would get sued and then legal troubles. I do understand why they did this. However, I don't like it. The Batarang itself and the stand feel just so very light. I mean, it's half a pound, maybe a quarter of a pound. It's really, 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 really light. And I would have liked something a little heavier. The stand itself feels hollow. Batarang, it's plastic, but it just, I don't know, it doesn't do a whole lot for me. It does have this kind of scratched effect all over it. So it looks like it is used, and actually some of the paint is rubbed off on the side. So I understand why they did that, to make it like it's an actual worn battering. But this could have been so much more. I'm hoping at some point to find a way to remove this and then kind of spray paint this in a much better looking black, and then add some silver detailing to the edges as if it's been worn through and hitting things. But this could have been done a whole lot better. And if anybody has figured out a way to remove this, it's glued in place, for those of you who can't tell. And it's sealed in there. But if you have figured out a way to take the Batarang off the stand without breaking either one, let me know. I would like to have this, in my hand to hold it without having to hold the stand. But on its own, it's all right. It's good for display. It's just I would have liked something a little better, So there is that. Next, we get the Arkham Journal. Look on the front here. You see Arkham is embossed in it. Is it embossed? Or is, I don't know, embedded embossed? I don't know. But you have Arkham kind of stamped in there. It's used stamped. It's pretty cool little effect all around here. You see there's two A's on the front buttons. And you can actually untie the journal. And this is where it goes from a really cool leather journal to your basic ordinary game booklets. This is kind of a letdown. I mean, I would have liked if it was like an actual leather-bound book, even pleather. Just have something a little different, not just your standard game booklet. But inside this, you will find bios of key characters in Batman. You get Joker, you get Victor Zsasz, you get Harley Quinn, the Scarecrow, the Ventriloquist. You get all these people in it. And at the end, you even get Batman. You get Warden Sharp, who is the Warden of Arkham. You get the Commissioner Gordon's in there somewhere. I mean, you get a lot of bios. So if you are someone who's been at a loop on Batman for many years, you can kind of play catch up and read some of these bios. I mean, there's most likely every villain that Batman's ever faced in there. It's kind of cool. And even if you are someone who's kept up with Batman, it could be fun to kind of read these things to kind of, you know, refresh your mind kind of deal. And once you get it tied off, it's back to a journal. Overall, it looks really good like this. It's just when you open it, I would like more, I guess. But it looks pretty cool. Then you get this. It is a sticker on the front, but on the back, there is a prepaid redemption code for the Crime Alley Challenge maps. My understanding is at some point this will be released on Xbox Live for purchase. But for those of you who... I honestly don't know if it's just because it's the collector's edition or if it's because you pre-ordered or what, but you get a special code for some challenge maps. I have downloaded it, but I have not played them, so I don't know if they're really good or not. I have heard some people have like Scarecrow challenge maps, so it'd be really cool if that was this, but I highly doubt it, and I don't say anything about a Scarecrow map in here. But anyway, moving on. You have a mini comic called The Road to Arkham, and like this probably says, it leads up to Arkham Asylum. Goes with Batman catching the Joker. The artwork is as well as can be expected. And then at the end, it ends with Batman taking the Joker to Arkham. It's a mini comic, so it's nothing really too spectacular, but if you do like having backstories for things, you would probably enjoy this. Then you got your standard game booklet, if I can actually get it out of there. The cover looks nice. Throughout it, there are like little details to make it look like it fits in with the whole Joker theme, but it's your standard book. It's got, you know, what buttons do what gadgets do this, just your standard booklet. Nothing really too spectacular about it. Now, under the final piece of this is the two-disc edition of the game. Open it up here. It's this nice little sleeve. It looks like it's a desk to me or something. It looks like it's wood. I don't know. And here you have both discs. Disc 1 is the game, disc 2 is behind-the-scenes features. And I was really excited for this. I thought this would be a fun watch. I love behind-the-scenes things for movies, games, whatever. However, after watching it, I'm really let down. There are about 5 featurettes on the entire DVD. And they really don't do a whole lot. Some of the stuff included I've seen online. There's interviews with only Kevin Conroy, but no Mark Hamill. You see Kevin Conroy very briefly in the recording studio talking. You see Mark Hamill maybe 3 seconds worth. It definitely was a letdown. I mean, some of the stuff, you really don't take a whole lot. I was hoping for an actual in-depth look at how the game was thought of, how they wrote the story for it, when they decided to go with the voice cast for the animated series. I wanted to see a lot of behind-the-scenes stuff, and it's pretty much... Here's the score, here's the cinematography, here's the sound design, here's this. And each one is about 7 minutes, one of the featurettes is 4 minutes, and one is like 5 minutes. It was definitely a lot less than what I was expecting. And there are trailers for, you know, all the trailers for the game, the villains trailer, the combat, which you can also download for free with the Xbox Live service. So I was very let down by this. So now it comes to whether or not this is worth it. Before I made this video, before I watched this, I would have said, yeah, sure, why not? Because, I mean, the original retail price for Batman Arkham Asylum, at least for the 360, is about $60, okay? This edition is $90, at least on Amazon. So for $30, you're getting this really big case that will be hard to display anywhere because it's so massive. A DVD with stuff that will most likely be available online eventually, if it isn't already. The Batarang, which it looks good. I mean, it's all right looking, but it's definitely not what I was hoping for. So you get that. You get the mini comic that'll either be online somewhere, or at least the plot will be copied over on some forum. You could probably read it there. And you get the code for the challenge map, which at some point will be up for download on Xbox Live. And last but not least, you get the journal, which, while it looks nice, you could most likely find all the information inside and more on sites like Wikipedia. And, you know, the actual Batman Wiki. You can probably find bios, all of this stuff in there online already. So you're paying $30 for things you can really get either already on your own now or at some point later. And I hate to say this, but I don't think it's worth the extra $30. I really don't. And it kind of hurts to say that because I thought this would be a really fun thing to have. I mean, I was excited for it. And, you know, to some people, it probably is worth it, but to me, it's really just a letdown, especially the bonus stuff on the DVD. I was extremely let down by that. So it's really up to you. If you think it's worth it, go ahead and get it. If you have no interest in any of these, just get the plain version of the game. You'll probably still enjoy it. But that is it, guys. I hope you enjoyed the video. I hope you have a great day. Paul, I hope this is what you were hoping to see. I hope I've persuaded you to either buy it or not. Hope you guys have a great day, and I will see you around. Take care.